Okay, so chances are if you are into YouTube, you must have come across this particular person called Ali Abdal. So this particular person has taken productivity to a whole new level, to a point where it's almost a parody. How amazing is that? Another thing, you know, which I like about this particular guy is his editing process. I know he has an editor. He uses Final Cut Pro. I don't know what his editor uses. One of the things which I really, really like are its kind of titles which he uses in all his videos, especially this kind of, you know, custom titles with custom icons. I don't know where he gets them, but surely I really love it. I'm going to just make a small example of this particular kind of a title. But before this, let me just show you guys what I'm actually talking about, what kind of titles I'm actually talking about. And you know what's really parody? That you guys are not smashing that like button. I have never really said much about this, but now I think I'm going to be more frank in front of the computer. So just smash that particular like button so that it can, you know, play with that YouTube algorithm and we can rock this particular video and Ali Abdal sees this too. With that being said, I'm going to just show an example using one of his videos, such as this one, which is how to buy Bitcoin for beginners. This is one of the good topics. It is around 24 minutes long. Oh my God. So with that being said, let's just start. So yes, he is a much better YouTuber than I am. Most of his videos are very well produced. So Ali, if you are watching this, again, thank you so much for putting up such great content, man. It is just so good. With that being said, just take productivity a little less seriously, maybe. you know, to the point, I felt like making a video like the most productive birthday of my life, which was like a few weeks back. So maybe take a little bit easy here. With that being said, let's jump straight into this particular video and, you know.
All right, let's talk about crypto. Now, you've probably heard.
So yeah, first and foremost, you guys see a very good amount of icon animations right here. This is pretty good. Let me just, you know, reduce the sound a bit. Okay, so right here you guys can see this particular, you know, this particular box transition titles, which is just, you know, popping up from the bottom just like this. And these are these custom icons which I was talking about. Maybe we guys can find this on the internet. I found some free ones as well as some paid ones. So it is up to you which one you guys like, but of course, these are really cool and it is really soothing to his entire brand too. If you guys go to his website also, he has a loads of different kinds of custom icons inside his website. And regarding this particular titles in mind, I don't know whether there is any kind of pack like this because I have not seen this particular pack anywhere. But maybe there are, anyone must have made this because these are really simple to make. I'm going to show one example too in this particular video. But if these are custom made, pretty well done because I'm sure these guys take a lot of time to make this particular custom things. It takes a lot of time. So we're going to just replicate this particular title. It is pretty simple. But before that, let's jump straight into Google. If you guys know what that is, it is a search engine. Okay, so if you guys want to search this custom icons or this particular custom vectors, you guys can just search anything like, you know, vector icons, PNG. And go to images, you will get tons of different kinds of them. Most of them are not that good looking, which is the bad thing here. And whichever ones are good looking are mostly paid. Whenever you are searching these kind of icons, I would suggest go to Pinterest. It is one of the best places for finding these particular things. Like in this particular case, you guys can see this particular thing, which is from Creative Market, and it looks pretty good. There are loads of other examples to like this particular one, which looks pretty good too. And I guess it is 100 Lulu vector icons from designbeam.com. Let me just go to this particular website. And you know, there are some other paid ones also, just like this one, which is 370 flat business icons, which is for $17 for personal use, commercial, which is for YouTube. It is for $21. And you know, this particular designbeam.com, this looks pretty good. 100 icons. You guys can download it all for free, which is like crazy. There's another good website, which is called roundyicons.com. They have a good amount of free pack. They have a good amount of free icons. They also have paid icons too. If you guys want to custom design, they have that option too as well. But overall, this is a very good website. But the thing is, most of the free ones are not that applicable. Like in my case, I'm not really find too much relevance to my topic, but if you have those relevant topics and it is matching with the free icons, definitely try them. And there is another website. It is not a website, it is a portfolio in Behance. Let me just open this. You know, there is this particular guy called Alex, and he shows his design portfolio in Dribbble, and these are amazing. These are so good looking. These are animated too. So what else can one just ask for? One of the bad things is that most of these things cost a hell lot of money. So, you know, he sells them separately, which I understand because he must have taken a lot of time in making this. But the fact that, you know, it is not very financially applicable, because every time if you want to buy one thing separately, it will be a disaster. Like in this particular case, there are 12 animations for $49. But if I change the topic to something else, maybe I have to spend more. Maybe there's a gamer icon right here, which is around, I don't know. Okay, I don't think this is a sellable product. Okay, so this one maybe. Animated education icons, which costs around $40. So yeah, you actually get what you pay for. These are really good, really high quality icons. And also that is the reason why these are so costly. Again, these are some of the examples right here. I'm just going to, take any one of them. You know, just search Bitcoin vector icon PNG. And there are some decent ones, I would say, like this one. I'm going to just save this for the sake of, you know, showing you the thing. So yeah, we are in Final Cut Pro. I'm going to just show it in Final Cut Pro, but you guys can use the same process in Premiere Pro too. It is more or less the same thing. I'm going to just drag this particular icon right here. But before this, I'm going to just, you know, disable this. Go to titles, which is right here. Go to generators. Go to elements. Go to shapes. Drag this on the timeline just like this, and you're going to see a circle. After that, what you need to do is go to the inspector panel. Let me just close this. Go to the inspector panel. There's an outline color, which is green. I have to just change it to white. I don't want the outline. I don't really need the outline, basically. And change the shape to rectangle. But there are lots of other shapes also, which you can try. Just click on rectangle. It is going to be a rectangle. Now you have to add those roundiness, right? If you just look at Ali Abdal's ones, there is this particular roundiness. So what you need to do is you need to increase this particular roundiness just like this. But if you want to increase the width of this particular rectangle, just click on outline width, increase this just like this. It looks pretty decent, and you guys can play with the roundiness right here as well. So I feel this one looks pretty good as it is like here. Now I'm going to just drag this particular Bitcoin icon just like this. You know, reshape it. I mean, resize it just like here. So we're going to get this particular thing. Now we're going to add this particular title. Now in Final Cut Pro, just click on Ctrl plus T to get a title, just like this. And you know, just change the color all the way to black. Go to face, change the color, change it to black. You can choose any font which you want. I'm going to choose something called Proxima Nova. Go to semi-bold. And you know, what I'm going to type here. Subscribe to this channel and like this particular video, comment in this particular video, because we are going to play with this YouTube algorithm and we're going to make this particular video viral so that Ali sees it. So make sure to smash that like button as soon as possible. Again, coming back here, subscribe, change the, you know, Y position just like this, and you know, it's pretty much done. But there is no animation, right? There is no animation. We have to put this particular animation. Now there are two ways to do this. Now one way is pretty simple, just, you know, set up the keyframes. Another way is automatic way, which I like much better than this one, but I'm going to show it right here. One thing disadvantage to the second method is it is paid. Again, not sponsored by any way, but it is a very good option to save a lot of time in your hands. So, you know, just compound this particular clip by clicking Option plus G, just like this. You know, now I'm going to reposition this, you know, place it to the corner just like this. Now the first method is going to be just a simple one. So, you know, go to the transform panel, set a keyframe to the position, and you know, press the Y button and take this particular thing out of the frame to any position which you want. And then go a few frames later and change the Y back to its original position. I should have thought this through and remember the Y position, but anyway, the same thing goes here. Just like this, change the Y position back to its original one. And then, you know, this particular animation is done. It looks pretty good. It actually looks pretty good. And if you want to just, you know, end it here, then you guys can actually place another keyframe at the ending, just like this. Go few frames later, and then, you know, again, take the Y out of the frame. So, you know, it enters, it goes out. Looks pretty good, right? So now we're going to show the automatic method, which is pretty good. So for that, I'm going to just copy this particular clip, you know, remove all the keyframes from it. Right here, so there is this particular plugin called AdMotion from a company called Factory Effects. This is not sponsored in any way, but the fact that this is one of the good plugins to save a lot of time in doing keyframes is something which you guys must know. So again, Factory Effects. Now this is one of the good things right here which you can try, and it is called AdMotion. There are loads of other free plugins as well as paid plugins too here which you can try. Okay, we found it. So this is the one. It costs $50, but it is totally bang for the buck. So, you know, what this particular plugin does is basically it sets up automatic keyframes. You don't have to just, you know, drag, put the keyframe, reposition, etc. It does all of them automatically. How amazing is that? So yes, you guys can try out the trial version too. There is a small watermark which is almost negligible, but for professional users, of course, you cannot just have that. So you guys can absolutely try this for free. I have the full version right here. So there is one thing called AdMotion, just like this. So I'm going to just drag it on this particular screen, just like this. And you know, instantly you guys can see an automatic animation right here, which is good, but not that good. So how we are going to change it? So we're going to change it by doing something which is in the inspector panel. And it is going to be moving from A to B. So A is your original position, B is your changed position. And this is the A position, this is the B position. You have to change the A position. So this particular circle is the A position, which I'm going to drag just like this. And I have just dragged it out of the frame, just like this. I'm going to just drag it up a little bit more. And as you can see, it is done. Keyframe is done. And you know, the best part of using this particular plugin is the fact that it does not do this linearly. It is a very gradual keyframing. Like in this one, it moves gradually. Whereas in particular this one, it moves, you know, in an ease kind of fashion, in an ease graph kind of fashion. I don't know how to exactly say that. It is pretty hard to explain it. The fact that the first one goes linearly, like it goes in a straight fashion and moves. Whereas this one, it moves, you know, slowly and then again goes up. Like the speed accelerates. That is the best way for me to explain this. The speed accelerates for this one. And you guys can change this particular thing. For example, instantly, initially it will be in linear, but we're going to change it to ease. So, see, in this particular case, it looks much more seamless. I don't know how to exactly explain it to you guys. It is just the fact that it is accelerating. It is not like a linear wave. It is not like a linear function of a thing, which is in maths, which I don't know that well. It is accelerating in such a speed, which is more or less possible in After Effects, not in Final Cut Pro, up to that certain extent in Final Cut Pro compared to After Effects. But with this particular plugin, you guys can do so automatically, so seamlessly. But again, this is not like a compulsion. The free method was fine for something like titles. I guess it should be just bang for the buck. And yeah, that is like pretty much pretty good. Like it is pretty good. The title is done. You guys can make this as many times as possible, and this is the way you do so. Another thing which can stand out is that the fact that you use it so regularly, up to a certain extent, that it is a part of your brand. That is what Ali Abdal is doing right now. Most of his videos, including his thumbnails, such as this one maybe. Let's just go to his channel, latest videos. In this particular case, in the thumbnail also, you guys can see a lot of custom icons right here. In this particular video too, you guys can see a lot of custom icons. So this is what branding is all about. When you are using something to a certain extent that it is slowly and becoming your own thing, then it is something which you should definitely do every time you make something, because you know it is a part of your brand. And Ali Abdal has been creating some dope content right here. His post production is top notch, I would say. I know he is making money, man. Like, I know he is making like a million or at least 700k or 700k dollars or 800k dollars at least a year. Damn, man, like, you have created this particular productivity niche so well. Like, it is almost so good that it is like a parody at this particular point. Even if you guys just go to his comment section, like in this one, let's just go to his comment section. Even I think we are officially at the point when Ali is parodying himself. There was a funny one right here, which was, I guess, in the Valentine's Day one. So Ali is getting married, my instantly productive marriage. In a productivity comedy. Yeah, he actually made this particular niche. Like, he's something like, you don't have to, you know, formally and officially tell something, but when you are doing it to a certain extent that a massive audience sees and likes it, that is when you know that you have achieved that as a new thing, new trend, I would say. So with that being said, I guess this is a very simple video, but yeah, I hope you guys like this. This is a very simple kind of a title, tutorial come blog, come thing, which you know, hopefully you guys liked. So if you guys like this particular video, comment down below, smash that like button so that you know we guys can play with that YouTube algorithm. With that being said, I'm Pixel Sammy. We'll be back with another video soon. Peace.